welcome to my channel. I'm Tanya and I'm a travel vlogger. Now, funnily enough, today I'm vlogging from South Goa. Now, I say funny because just 2 days before coming here, I was in the high mountains of Spiti Valley. In case you guys have not watched my vlogs, I'm going to link it up here. So, I'm here in Goa with the Tripoto community, which is a really popular online portal for travelers, for putting out information for other travelers. And I'm staying at this wonderful property called Mayfair Hideaway Spa Resort. And this place is literally like a hideaway because look at all this foliage over here and all the greenery that covers the entire place. So if you see my room from a vantage point, you pretty much won't be able to see it. Now heading to the room itself, it's quite a nice room. I'm just gonna give you a slight glimpse of it. So this is my room and over there in the back, we have the dressing area and the bathroom, which is also really stunning. I arrived at this place last night and guys, I'm guilty of already having tried the gym and the pool over here because it's so lovely. And I'm serious about this, I have no chill in life ever. Even while I'm traveling, I can't bring myself to relax ever. So I just have to like do something engaging and active all the time when I'm traveling. So I already visited the gym also, which is awesome. But right now I'm kind of dying to get out of this resort and explore the rest of the places around because we are in Goa and I want to take you guys along with me on this journey. So the first step is that we are going to go and find ourselves a ride, which should preferably be something like a scooty maybe. Okay, so I found myself a place from where I can rent a scooty near my hotel. So in Goa, actually looking for a bike rental or a scooty rental is not as difficult because there are various options available here. So I'm not going to mention where did I exactly get it from because it'll kind of depend on which area you're living in and where do you want to rent a cycle or scooty or bike from. The rate of renting a scooty in Goa can be between 200 to 300 to 500 and will also depend on where do you rent it from and which season do you come in. Cavalism Mobor area and at Fisherman's Wharf right now, and after getting here I can tell why this place is so popular because the view is excellent, plus you get to dine against this view. So over here at Fisherman's Wharf, I'm trying some masala prawns and also some virgin mojito, and both the dishes are really nice. I wish I could spend more time here, but unfortunately I just received a call from my hotel that they have a complimentary sightseeing tour for the day, so we'll probably be covering more places around South Goa. And I think I don't mind the sightseeing tour at all because of the fact that the distances for the places that we're going to be heading to are going to be really large, so I don't have to drive for those. The meal at Fisherman's Wharf was great, but now I'm back to the hotel. In fact, just started from the hotel again for a complimentary sightseeing tour from the hotel itself. And mere saath yahan pe abhi Adhir bhaiya hai. Jo, bhai hum log kahan kahan jaane wale hain?
Jayenge pehle jayenge Mangesh Temple.
Mangesh Temple.
Uske baad Old Goa Church.
Old Goa Church.
Uske baad Miramar Beach.
Miramar Beach.
Uske baad Donapola.
Donapola. So the first stop over here for me is Mangesh Temple. But before even entering the temple, I was really craving some coconut water. Mangesh Temple, it's a Shiv temple and it's one of the largest in Goa. As is customary, recording inside the temple is not allowed, but this temple has a really long history. It was built before the Portuguese invasion and in the Madgao area, but after their invasion it had to be shifted to Mageshi village in 1560s, and it has been shifted once and renovated twice ever since.
Hey, tuka jai.
Tuka jai.
हाँ ये गुड लगता
गुड लगता
मुझे आंबट गुड लगता
आंबेट गुड लगता
आंबट गुड
आंबेट गुड
हाँ
इसका क्या मतलब हुआ
ये खट्टा मीठा
खट्टा मीठा तो ये खट्टा मीठा पापड़ है और आंटी मुझे कोंकणी सिखा रही है So there was a time when the population of Goa was predominantly Christian, but now currently it is 66% Hindu, and also the primary language that is spoken over here is Konkani, and I just bought myself some aam papad while learning Konkani. गलत चीज खरीद ली आई बीन मंचिंग ऑन दिस आम पापड़ फॉर अ रियली लॉन्ग टाइम नाउ बट इन अनदर न्यूज वी मेड इट टू ओल्ड गोवा चर्च सो दिस चर्च इज कॉल्ड द बेसिलिका ऑफ बॉम जीसस एंड आई रिमेंबर रीडिंग अबाउट इट इन माई हिस्ट्री बुक्स व्हेन आई वाज इन स्कूल एंड द रीजन वाई दिस चर्च इज रियली पॉपुलर इज बिकॉज इट हाउसेज द मॉर्टल रिमेन्स ऑफ सेंट फ्रांसिस जेवियर And you can actually see the mummified body inside this church. Now, videography is not allowed near that body. So you guys will have to come here and see it for yourself. But it's quite fascinating because especially when you visit some place that you've read about in school, it feels cool. यहाँ के क्रोज भी आम पापड़ खा रहे हैं सो गाइज आफ्टर द चर्च द नेक्स्ट प्लेस दैट आई एम एट इज कॉल्ड डोना पोला जेटी पॉइंट एंड दिस प्लेस हैज अ लॉट ऑफ मिथ्स अटैच्ड टू इट दैट डोना एंड पोला वर टू डिफरेंट पीपल एंड दैट दे लव्ड ईच अदर बट दे कुडंट बी टुगेदर सो दे सुसाइडेड दे कमिटेड सुसाइड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट सो ऐसे करके बहुत सारे मिथ्स यहाँ से अटैच्ड हैं बट द रियल स्टोरी इज दैट डोना पोला वॉज वन पर्सन एंड इट वॉज अ फीमेल हु बिलोंग टू एन एफ्लुएंट फैमिली एंड शी बिलीव्ड इन अ लॉट ऑफ चैरिटी सो दिस विलेज वॉज नेम्ड आफ्टर हर डेथ विच इज वाई दिस जेटी पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड डोना पोला एंड नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ urban legends or myths. Guys, it's another morning here in Goa and last night I ended my vlog at Dona Paula and I think I completely forgot to mention that Dona Paula is the most famous because of a few significant Hindi movie scenes over there like Singham and one other movie that I can't seem to place so in case you guys know please let me know in comments so after I got back from over there I ate dinner at the resort itself and also today morning's breakfast today I'm pretty much on my own because I'm not using the hotel services to be able to go out so I got on Tripoto a while back and formulated a basic plan for myself of a few really interesting things here in South Goa so the first place I'm here at today is called Martin's Corner and Martin's Corner is a really well renowned restaurant here in South Goa if you're in this area you cannot miss the place because the food is supposedly really great and I met Shambhavi here and so we guys met through Instagram and she's introducing me to Goan food here because she is a fellow Goan not fellow actually she's a Goan I'm not a Goan but that's awesome because I get recommendations from somebody who's a local here We tried a bunch of interesting things thanks to her recommendations. We tried some chicken kafriyal, some prawn curry, rice, and also mackerel resha though.
Yeah.
Which is your favorite dish?
I like everything. What is your favorite dish?
I think I really like prawn curry and resha though. I think those are two things that I really enjoyed having. And guys, Shambhavi is so nice. She also got me some fresh made bibinka from a local store which is close to her place. And in case you don't know what bibinka is, it's a dessert, a Goan dessert,
yeah,
right? So I'm super excited about trying it. And in case you're in Goa, you have to try bibinka because how popular is it on a scale of 1 to 10 here?
I think about 8.
Okay guys, you won't believe what happened. I was on my way after Martin's to Mobor Beach because I had a kayaking session over there and turns out that I experienced Goan rain finally, and I'm fully drenched at the moment. My phone is fully drenched, thank God it's waterproof. And yeah, I'm just standing here at the store called Maxim's, which is quite a popular store in Goa. Enjoying the rains. So you know, a while back I was feeling really dejected because it started raining and I hadn't even been to a single beach in Goa yet. But you know what happens after rainfall? You see the best sunset. So I made it to a beach, guys. I'm here at Mobor Beach, and South Goan beaches are said to be one of the prettiest and cleanest and emptiest beaches of all beaches in Goa. And look at how many people are present here. Guys, it's my final day here in Goa and I'm sitting at the breakfast table to have my breakfast. They usually have a buffet menu here at Mayfair to be able to serve people, all the guests who are here. The food is great, but the best part that I like about their service is that they have a really friendly staff, and their staff literally goes to each and every table and asks if the person who's eating is having a good day and if their meal is nice. In fact, even the head chef comes down to you and asks if the food is good, and that is something I haven't seen at a lot of places. So guys, this what you see behind me is all Sal River. It's actually a backwater river, and while Goa is really popular for its beaches, its backwaters are also just as pretty, so don't miss out on the opportunity of going kayaking here. Since it's my last day here in Goa today, I thought I'll take it easy and just walk around my resort where I was staying at. I really wanted to be going kayaking yesterday, but since the weather was not great, I couldn't do it. But guys, if you're in South Goa, don't forget on the opportunity of going kayaking here. Okay guys, so I'm headed to the airport now, and with this we come to an end of this vlog in Goa. So all thanks to Tripoto community for bringing me here to Goa, and if you guys would also like to start contributing to Tripoto community as a Tripoto wanderer, be sure to sign up on their page. I'll leave the link in the description box below so that you can also start contributing, start sharing your experiences. Make sure to like this video, share this video and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time from another place in another travel vlog. Bye bye.